IVM.
Did you know that your energy intake shouldn't just be from carbs? It should also include good fats and proteins. And this is something that the Whole Truth has taken to heart in order to provide you with a balanced breakfast option called the Perfect Breakfast. This is a range of delicious muesli that comes in three flavors: nuts, fruits, and seeds, quinoa choco crunch, and almond choco crunch. When you eat this muesli, only 50% of your energy comes from carbs. The rest is from all natural good fats and proteins. Just visit thewholetruthfoods.com and use the coupon code HABIT on checkout to get an awesome 20% discount. Hello and welcome to the Habit Coach podcast, the bite-sized podcast filled with quick and easy actionable habits. Remember, great habits create that awesome life. I am Ashton Doctor, your Habit Coach. And today's fun fact of the day has to do with anger. Did you know that anger is predominantly a physical reaction? You will notice that your hair stands on end. You clench your fists. You grit your teeth. Your heartbeat increases and your palms are sweaty and your muscles tighten. This is the classical adrenaline response, which is all about fight or flight. Run away from the danger or fight it for your life. In modern society, showing anger is frowned upon. However, it is a very common reaction when we were animals. Look at dogs and how they react when they see another dog in their territory. Look at how kids react when their favorite toy is taken away from them. Fists flying, legs kicking, screaming, and in a full-blown tantrum. It, after all, feels like a threat to their life. Now, think about how adults are supposed to behave. We are not allowed to get angry, or feel anger, or act in anger. But the truth is, we do feel anger. We do want to throw our hands in the air. We do want to kick the sofa, slam the door. We do want to throw things against the wall. Yet, we are not allowed to. We are expected to behave in a dignified way. We're supposed to keep our emotions in check and not lose our cool. But the animal inside us rages on. Do you know this feeling? Do you know what I mean? There are days when you just want to explode, but have to bottle it down. There are good reasons for not being angry. You can take better decisions with a calm mind. You do not need to burn bridges and ruin friendships. You don't end up destroying the TV and need to spend more on a new one. But most importantly, you don't hurt someone physically. Hitting someone and hurting them is definitely not okay. Anger is such a normal human response that no one teaches us about it. We're all expected to know how to deal with anger. Then we hear people say things like, oh, they have anger issues. We hear stories about physical violence. For most of us, the only advice we hear about anger is to count backwards from 10. Or then take a long, deep breath. However, these are useless things when we want to rage. Remember, anger is a physiological response. So you have to allow for that physiological response. Imagine you are like a pressure cooker. You don't want the pressure cooker to explode, which is rage. You want the pressure cooker to let out the steam in a controlled manner. When I was a child, I wanted to hit and throw a tantrum. My mom would tell me, go punch a pillow instead. And I would go to town on that pillow, punching it, throwing it, and screaming into it. My body would be shaking, my eyes streaming with tears and clothes sweaty. In a few minutes, I would have tired myself out and I would return to normal. If I had not done that, who knows how long I would have remained angry and screaming. We as adults are just big babies after all. And when you are angry, a pillow can be your best tool. Punch it, hit it, shake it, scream into it. Do what comes naturally to you and your body. Direct that anger at the pillow and not at anyone or anything else. We use a pillow to keep others safe as well as ourselves safe. We do not want to hurt ourselves just because of a moment of anger. I don't want you to picture someone's face on the pillow because this anger is not directed at someone. This anger is just about releasing the physical tension that is stored in your body. And I've done a whole podcast on how to do a post-mortem on your anger after it is gone. Listen to that episode so you know what to do next. So your simple habit for dealing with anger starts by punching a pillow. Go to your room or a safe space. Find a pillow and just punch it. Let the physical energy release. Remember, the key is for you and others around you to be safe. So don't punch a wall or a door or anything else. Punch a pillow. Don't direct the anger at someone by picturing their face or shouting their name. Once the anger is gone, you can think clearly and make better choices. So start these habits and share with us your progress using the hashtag TheHabitCoach. If you like this podcast, don't forget to check out other interesting podcasts on the IVM network. You can listen to us on the IVM Podcast app or ivmpodcast.com. You can also follow us on social media. We are at IVM Podcasts on Twitter and Instagram. If you want to reach out to me, I am Ashtin Doc on Twitter and Instagram. You can find lots more information on my website, awesome180.com, or check out different content on my YouTube channel called AWESOME180. That's Awesome180.
I hope you enjoyed that show. If you aren't following us on social media, please do. We're IVM Podcasts on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. We'd like to thank our sponsors on the network this week, Sita Tires and thewholetruthfoods.com. Thank you for your support. We did a bunch of cock and bulls this week. We had guests like Ayushi Amin and Puneet Pania for that. Besides that, Vasanti Hariprakash was on, as well as Jay Alani, a paranormal investigator. Really, really great week on Cyrus Says. Do check it out. Tune into This Round Is On Me for an episode recorded from Gulmarg featuring one of India's professional alpine skiers, Arif Khan, who's looking forward to representing India at the Beijing Olympics. On The Habit Coach, Ashton has a chat with Kunal Rajput, the popular fitness trainer who recently completed 7 rounds of his Unlock workout series. The reunified, simplified gang of Tony, Naren, Chuck, and Shrikant discussed NFTs on the latest episode. On The Millennial Athlete, Tanvi and Shlok looked back at all the England championships of the year so far and discussed the interesting highlights of the same. Also, on Thale Harate Our Kannada podcast, Ganesh spoke to Archana Shyam of Antaranga Theatre in the latest episode. And on Kadai podcast, our Tamil show, Kavita Jiva shed light in another story about the bravery and excellence in the governance of the Pallava dynasty. And with that, I hope to see you again next week.
Whether you're an established sports person or a budding one, or simply a sports enthusiast, join us, Tanvi and Shlok.
We are two passionate pro badminton players talking policy, mindset and everything sport.
So tune in to The Millennial Athlete every Monday.
Only on the IVM Podcast Network.
Trust us, it's gonna be lit.